Hello guys, today we're going to learn on how to create emails in ClientZone. Afrihost is ClientZone anyway. Yeah, Afrihost is the company which I host my website with, and it's a very good company and very cheap company. Without not wasting a lot of time, click on any of your browser, and I use Brave anyway. That's the browser I use. He is Brave. Click on Brave. You can go to client. You can even go to Google if you wanna go get it there quicker. Say Google. Then you say client. You can say Afrihost. Client Zone. Is what we're looking for. Okay, you can click here. So here it will ask you username and password. I'm using my email as my username. Yes, you log in. It will send you OTP, the OTP. So you check your phone, the OTP, then you put in the OTP. Okay, that's what I received on my phone. Then you log in. Yes, after you've logged in, you can see a couple of things here. You can go to billing. If you want to go to billing, you can go to my account, you can go to support and other services, mobile connectivity, everything. So this menu, you can just go to, if you want to create emails, you click on hosting, then you select the domain you want to create emails from. Then when you're there, you click on, you can see these, you don't click here like emails or whatever. The best way is to click on see panel, because you're gonna get a lot of things here anyway. Then you click on log into see panel. It stopped me because I'm connected to another something which blocked my, let me switch it off, let me pause. Yes guys, I'm back, and we are like, I tried to pause what was stopping me to click or to go on that. So what I'm gonna do, we're gonna go back and say client zone. No, it's fine, it's yeah, it's fine, the window popped up. So what you see here, there's a lot of things here to do. This is your file manager. If you have a website, you're gonna click here, and that's where when you're going to drop your files for your website. And you can read on to these things, all of this. You can see here, it shows you that the databases I have, like 5 out of 5 is 100%, because the domain I bought, they gave me 5 databases. So you can see the space I have on the disk. I've used 20%, but here I've used 100%. So anyway, we're here for emails, but it's also relevant for you to know some couple of things you did not know. So you have to read on each and every icon here and click on them and see how they work. So here, this section is where people who use some other things like PAL, like that's where they come and choose the software they want to use anyway. So we go down here, this is cron job. That's where you can set up your script which you want to be automated and run in on any time you want. Maybe you say, I want to run a script which is gonna send people SMSs each and every Tuesday around 9. So you can create a script like that. Then you set it here in your cron job. Then does that thing for you instead of being clicking and clicking, sending SMSs all the time or emails. Anyway, anything you want to set, this is the software you go and set up and do your stuff there. So when we go down here, you can see a lot of software software is here, and you can see Afrihost extra. But now here, that's where you can create your databases, MySQL, PHP, MyAdmin, MySQL is here, everything. So anything doing with the database is here. So then we come to our section we came in here for. So what we want to do is want to set up emails or to create emails for, like, you know, when you have a company called mycompany.co.za, you created a website already, so, and you don't want to use maybe things like Gmail, Ymail and stuff, you know. People in business, they really respect you when you have emails like which, like the email starts like maybe info@mycompany.co.za or .com or dot whatever. Yeah, so that's where a lot of companies, it's difficult to find a big company using Gmail, a Ymail, you know, those Yahoo mails and stuff. I'm not saying they are not relevant, they are relevant, but if you have emails like company emails, it gives a different image on your customers. So Afrihost has these things which are easy to set. You don't have to pay somebody to create for you some emails for your company. It's very easy. So as the steps are so easy, so we're going to start to create our emails here. So other stuff, there are many stuffs here whereby you can see your visitors. You can click on that if you want to see how many people visited your domain and things like that. I can't see any data, I don't know why. Okay, we can go back and we go here. Let me see something. This is where you set your SSL and stuff like that for security people. When we talk about the HTTPS, yeah, here, that's when you set that, though you have to buy some license for that. But anyway, Afrihost offered me a free one for 3 months, and that's the thing. So then let's go back here. You click on email accounts. So here, these are all the emails I've created already. So these emails, I already created them, and look how they look like. These emails, they can show you that this has never been used, this has never been used, almost this like 0.0%, these, and here, this is the only email which has been active a lot. So all of them, they are working. But now, in case somebody connect device, okay, you can play with this also. If you can say connect devices, if you click there, it will show you the setups and stuff if you want to set up those setups, like, you understand. So this is where you come and see if you, this is the username, this, you get the password. Then if you want to use the IMAP or you want to use this, you can set it up like this and this. So okay, what we're gonna do here, we can go back and create one email, and that email is gonna be called create. So I'm gonna create here and say create. I'm trying to create a new email. So I'm gonna create an email called learn. So this email is gonna be called learn@kingmusa.co.za. So I don't have to type this, or it's already there. So also I have to choose the password. I can create a password, and let me say the password is gonna be, yes. Or if you don't want to create a password, you can generate a password. Anyway, if you click on generate, it has generated a password for you, so you can use this password to do your stuff. But anyway, I won't take a generated password. I'm gonna create my own password, because sometimes a generated password becomes so difficult to remember. So I'm gonna create, make sure your password is at least a capital A, maybe a symbol like @. Let me show you how it's gonna work. Like here, you can click, like maybe I'd put a capital D symbol, then they need a letter at least. I'm gonna say 073. Then I can maybe say REST, it's already enter strong password. It does, because there's a word, that's why it said that. That's okay. I'll say capital D at star W T M 7. Yeah, this is fine. So our password is D at 073 star WTM 7. So that's what we have. So I will change it anyway. And yes, I've created a new password, and this is how to create an email. So you can give it a limit. You can say how many megabytes you want this guy to use. Maybe you're creating it for somebody in your company. So what you do, you can leave it the way it is, and but the problem is, like, when it becomes full, you're gonna do what, this limit if is hit, so you're gonna come back and set new. But if you want something at least bigger, you can give this person maybe 1,000 or 500 or stuff, whatever you say. Okay, or you can say, you can give him a gig if you want to. Then you say, okay, I'm gonna give this guy a gig, 1 gig, okay, which is okay. Then you just stay. After clicking, you can stay on this page. You say click, yes, we've created. You can see it tells us here that success, you created learn at King Mosado. So if you want to view it, you can view it if you want to. So yeah, so here they say manage. You click on manage if you want to. You can see what's going on here. So in case you have a client who doesn't want to pay you in time, and you want to block his or her emails, you just click there on manage. You click on suspend. You get me? Once you click on suspend, you can also click on suspend login. You can also click on suspend outgoing emails. You understand? So after that, then you say update. When you update, this guy will never ever do what, send or receive emails until when he pays you. So when he pays you, come back to the same email. You can see there's this symbol. It means this thing is restricted, so this guy cannot use his emails. Then you go back here and you take out these sanctions you put on him. You click here, you click here, you click here, and save. You know, some clients have that tendency of not wanting to pay, so you just disable their emails, don't fight with them, that's all. So you can also go here and say manage. So when you click on manage, no, we wanted to go to something else. I'm sorry, guys. You can say, you can click here and say connect device. So here is when they show you the setup on how to set up your email on Outlook. So you know, if you go to Outlook, these are the settings you have to use. So it depends sometimes on which internet service provider you're using, and if it's different from Afrihost, sometimes you might use their SMTP. Like if you're using Telkom or you're using MTN or Cell C, if you're connecting to your what your if you want to change this SMTP, if you use this and doesn't work, so what you do, you go to Google and say google.com. you can even say Afrihost SMTP, then click there. You can see they show you Afrihost SMTP. You can see it says SMTP at afrihost.com, and also pop, it comes and say DSL mail.afrihost.co.z. In case you're looking for Telkom, you can say Telkom SMTP. But anyway, Yes, you can see Telkom SMTP. Everything comes here in Google. So it depends on which network you're using. So you can create the SMTP based on that. Set up your SMTP based on your network. Guys, that was the tutorial on how to set up your emails. But still, you can also go back here. And please, guys, don't forget to subscribe. And you can ask a lot of questions if you want about creating emails, about doing anything Afrihost. So, because I'm using Afrihost, it will be easy for me to to create another tutorial on Afrihost. So, if you want to delete the account, you can delete that account and say delete. Yes, I've deleted that account. Just it was for test, and also it says success. You deleted. Learn what. Okay. Thanks, guys, for watching. See you in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe.